Draught animals. Animals which are used for carrying load or pulling heavy things, they are called as draught animals, or we call them as beast of burden. In India, cattle, usually bullocks or male buffaloes, they are used for pulling carts and for agricultural work, such as pulling plow or running sugarcane, crushing or oil pressing equipment. Horse, donkey, mules, they all are draught animals. In arid regions, same work is done by the means of camel. Elephant is also one of the draught animal. Now, food and health of livestock. Livestock means the animals which we keep for their product. The feed means food or fodder given to the animal must be nutritious, containing adequate amount of nutrients which are required by them. Nutrients means carbohydrate, fats, proteins, minerals or vitamins. The amount of mixed nutrients are worked out accordingly to the age, health of the animal. Like us, nutrients, the requirement of nutrients, it depend upon the age, health and type of work that animal is performing. The work done by an animal include the production of food. Cattle, including cow, buffaloes, bullocks, they are feed on grasses and leaves. They are also given some special feeds called as concentrates. Means along with these grasses or leaves, they are fed with concentrates. Now these concentrates include oil cakes, cereals, gram or bran. And the fodder, that is grasses, they are elephant grass, Jinja grass, Sudan grass, Barsim. These grasses are given to the cattle. Goat and sheep, they are also feed on grasses and farm waste. In addition to these grasses and farm waste, they are given food supplements like grains, gram or oil cakes. Pig, they are generally given a low fiber feed which is made up of cereals and vegetables. Poultry feed include again cereal, groundnut cake, fish meal or meat meal, and it is prepared from the waste in the processing of fish and meat. But the domestic animals are vulnerable to many diseases. Now, like after feeding, the another thing which animal husbandry look after, that is their care. That is, most of the animals, they are also very vulnerable to number of diseases which are caused by pathogens like bacteria, fungi or viruses. They are also suffered by or afflicted by internal and external parasites like tapeworm and ticks. Tapeworm is internal parasite and ticks, they are ectoparasite, means external parasite. Now, we can avoid these diseases in our domestic animals by keeping their shelter clean and ensuring an adequate amount of diet to them. With an overcrowd and dirty shelter, always encourage the spread of diseases. So their shelter should be well ventilated and clean. So this is how we can prevent diseases in animals also. Now next, we are going to start with production and management of fish.